storms that were in Brevard County, they're weakening right now. You like that?
I do. A little bit of rain, a little bit of wind, but I think for the most part they're going to be in pretty good shape. Let me take you outside, Jim and Martha, show you what's going on across central Florida. We had stormy skies over downtown Orlando just a short time ago, getting some peekaboo sunshine out there already. And farther off to the west, look at this, Claremont. We've got sunshine over the lake out there, a few clouds. It's going to be a nice sunset there and a nice evening across a good chunk of central Florida as the storms are now in the wind-down stage. Let's take a look now at Viper Plus here, show you what it looks like. Much of that energy from just a short time ago significantly weakening here from, let's call it, over towards Cape Canaveral, just east of Holapa. Still some pretty good showers and some thunderstorms, but again, this is definitely in a weakening mode. There's State Highway 520, Citrus Boulevard right through Cocoa. Just a nice little downpour here. We had south and west. Here's Deer Park. There's Holapa. You can see the evolution pulsing up over towards Holapa, but once it passed over 441, it's in that weakening mode, so that is certainly some good news. We'll watch this for Palm Bay over towards Melbourne over the next half hour to 45 minutes. In the back end of this, over towards Fort Meade, Lake Wales, and Frostproof, some pretty good showers and some thunderstorms here, but north and west of this corridor, it's a good-looking afternoon up towards Ocala and Leesburg, but let's talk lightning strikes here from this afternoon, late morning, from about 11:30 to 5:30, almost 20,000 lightning strikes in that six-hour window. So, again, for the evening events for the students after school, we're going to be in much better shape here. 81 Palm Coast, 72 downtown, 84 Leesburg, 86 the Villages, 82 in Ocala. So where it's not raining, we're in the 80s, where it's been raining or just ending, the temperatures are in the 70s. And with the afternoon showers and thunderstorms, the winds are quite chaotic all over the place. That's typical when you get outflow boundaries, when you get sea breeze collisions. Again, that's a normal, typical afternoon for us here in central Florida. Palm Coast in the morning, 69, 70 in Sanford. Right along the river, there can be some late night fog developing there, so we'll watch that carefully. There's Ocala coming in at about 68, Melbourne running right around 71 in the morning. As we take a look at that forecast map through late tonight and tomorrow, there is a front to the north. There is a little bit of residual moisture lingering throughout much of central Florida, and the models are indeed picking up on that. Some late day showers and some thunderstorms, especially with the approach down of that East Coast sea breeze. Heavier totals south and east of Orlando. Lighter amounts, however, as you work your way north and west. I think Ocala on west, we're probably going to be dry as we head into Tuesday afternoon. So having said that, let's take a look down the forecast highs for tomorrow. Sanford, you're going to be a 90. Ocala, you're going to be a 90. Downtown, 89. Even along the coast with that west-southwesterly offshore regime, we are talking about temperatures running in the mid to the upper 80s. Let's take a look now at the midweek forecast. Front goes by to the north. Big ridge of high pressure builds on in. We stay warm. We stay dry. Afternoon high temperatures now Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday approaching the 90-degree mark with a bit more of an onshore flow as we head into the weekend. We'll watch that. It's going to be continued hot, but we'll have to watch the rip current threat as we head into the upcoming weekend, especially by Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. But that is weather with timing. Jim and Martha, sunny and dry, temps right around 90.